Hello, everyone. Welcome to week 10 of your art classes, and that's week November 9 through November 13th. Last week, we finished our crayon resist leaf drop paintings, and some of you may have started doing some practice sketches for your pumpkins. What I'm going to ask you to do is what we call a contour line drawing. We're going to do it first in either pencil or marker so that you can practice the contour line drawings. What I would like you to do is to maybe get one of your pumpkins from outside and put it in front of you and just kind of follow the line of the pumpkin. We're not coloring it in. We're not shading it. It's an observational drawing, and we're observing how the line curves and try to do a sketch that would replicate those curves. Now, last week when we did our leaf drawings, we did some overlapping. As you can see, there's a large pumpkin in front of a small pumpkin. We're gonna be doing this in glue after we expert at drawing these pumpkins with pens or with pencils. And then we're gonna draw it in glue. So what you're going to need today to get started is a piece of white paper. I'm using a larger sheet, 12 by 18, but you can use, if you're working from home, you can use a small sheet. That works out fine. What I'm going to do is I'm going to try and show you how I would do my contour line drawing. So notice how I'm holding my wrist. If you kind of just swing your wrist around like so, you'll get kind of a curve. And this curve should be duplicated or repeated inside the pumpkin. Notice how I'm smoothing my wrist. You could also turn your paper and move it this way as well. You would have the stem coming out of the pumpkin. Now I'm going to put one behind here, and this one's going to be kind of a short, squat one. So I'm going to have it come like this. And remember, pumpkins are kind of irregular. They're not all exactly the perfectly geometric shapes. They're what we call organic shapes, which means they're not perfectly round or perfectly oval. Maybe I'll do a third one. Maybe I'll do another one going behind this one. And what I might do, remember our overlapping, when we lift over the, this one's kind of crooked. I kind of like that one. You lift your pen when you're going behind the pumpkin that's in front. So here's my three pumpkins. You would also need to put a patch underneath it. You'll see why later, but those pumpkins, instead of just floating in midair, it's going to be grounded on a patch of earth or hay or whatever you like. So once you have an idea of how you're going to draw your pumpkins, and do a few of them so you feel competent in drawing them. What we're going to do is we are going to draw them now with Elmer's glue on black paper. It doesn't have to look exactly like your sketch, but I like to put my sketch up in front of me so I can kind of look at it and have a point of reference when I'm doing my pumpkins. So, again, I'll move this down. You're going to use some Elmer's glue. And what I like to do is get it going first, make sure that it's coming out nice and smooth. And I'm going to draw my first pumpkin here. Try to get a nice smooth line. This is my contour line drawing in glue. And then I'll do the stem. Try not to get it too thick. And then I had a smaller one behind it. And of course, it doesn't have to be perfect because these are organic shapes. They occur in nature. So they are not perfect like a machine would do it. And here's my stem. Maybe I'll do one more. Okay, that was the big one. I'm going to put this big one right behind this one here. So that there's an overlap. You can take up most of the paper. I would leave some negative space like we discussed last week because we can add some interesting treatments for your negative space. What we're going to do is let this dry, and next week we're going to fill in these organic shapes. Come on, come on. With chalk pastel. So here's the bottom. This is what my pumpkins are sitting on, kind of a patch. Okay, maybe I'll do some squiggly vines coming out of my pumpkins. And you'll see what we'll do with them next time. I think I'll leave that one. Okay, so these are my pumpkin shapes that I did the contour line drawing in Elmer's glue. Now it's important that you keep it flat and put it aside to dry. Next week we're going to be using chalk pastels to fill in those shapes. So for this week I would like you to do some practice pumpkins. You can get them from a still life, you can take a pumpkin from outside, or you kind of know, practice it. You're doing the contour line drawings, just the outside lines and where the contour line is repeated throughout the pumpkin. You're going to give it some stems and you're going to give it a base upon which it will sit. Next week, we're going to add some chalk pastels to it and we're going to fill in those pumpkins, beautiful autumn chalk pastel. And we're going to use the autumn colors, and we're going to fill in the vines and the patch. And have some fun with it. I think you're going to like this. They turn out really, really good. So as long as you practice your drawing first, and then kind of do a couple of practice ones in glue. If you can get black paper, great. You could do it on white paper too. If you're in school and you would like to come in and take some black paper from the art room, you're certainly welcome to do that. So if you are working distantly this week, please show me on Flipgrid how it came out, okay? And then next week, I will show you how we treat the pumpkin with the pastels. So have a beautiful week, everybody. See you next time.